Hi everyone, my name is Natalie. Today I wanted to do a super chill video just talking about what I'm currently reading and basically doing a Friday Reads video because I haven't done one of these in a while and I feel like the most recent videos I've been doing more review and discussion videos and more, I think, like structured videos, and today I just wanted to chat with you and talk about what I'm currently reading and just show you my regular problem of reading too many books at the same time, because that is what is happening at the moment. So first off, we have my ebook that I'm currently reading, which is Charles Elwood or The Infidel Converted. And this is by O.A. Brownson. Yeah, this was published in the middle of the 19th century, and this is basically a story about an atheist who is, he's an atheist in the Victorian era, and he is very open with the fact that he doesn't really believe in Christianity, and he finds it very hypocritical and contradictory, and basically all of the people there in this little village where he lives are trying to convert him to become a Christian. And he, at the beginning of the book, he is having a conversation with one of the sort of training to become a priest kind of people who come to his home, and they are discussing religion, and they talk about like a devout person or and what that does, what that means, and who should be allowed to judge what the Bible says or what God meant with things in the Bible and everything. So the conversation itself was really interesting, and I found it to be very refreshing in coming from the Victorian era. I've mostly read books from this era that have been religious. All of the characters basically are religious, so I find this really refreshing and something I haven't really experienced or found before. And I found this book through a short story that I read. So I read The End of Mr. Y in January, and in that book there was a quote from one of the Edgar Allan Poe stories, short stories. His Miracle Revelation, I think, was the name of the short story. So I read that short story because of the quote in the book. And then in that short story, this book is mentioned. So I kind of went three steps to get to this book. But yeah, I'm really enjoying this so far. I haven't really picked it up in the last few days. But I really enjoyed the beginning of it, so I'm looking forward to continuing on with this. Another book that I sort of started in January and put aside while I was finishing other things is Mythos by Stephen Fry. And this is a book that came out in the end of 2017. This is basically Greek mythology retold in a humorous fashion. And it's a lot of the myths that you probably are familiar with in one way or another. They are very Greek myth and Greek gods and goddesses are very prevalent in the modern times. So you're probably familiar with all of their names and some of their myths. But I really want to get more into Greek mythology and Greek ancient literature. So I was really interested in this. I really wanted to read Stephen Fry as well. I bought this at the beginning of the year and started reading it immediately. And I'm about halfway through, really enjoying it. It's pretty basic in the way of mythology. I think it's a pretty good introduction to Greek mythology if you're interested. So I will be continuing on with this and hopefully finish it soon, because I've had this on my nightstand for a while. The book that I'm sort of actively reading at the moment, or the book that I'm most actively reading at the moment, is Let's Pretend This Never Happened, a mostly true memoir by Jenny Lawson. And this is as the title says, a memoir by Jenny Lawson about her growing up in Texas and her very weird family, and about her work. And a lot of this is also about her anxiety and her sort of dealing with her mental problems, while also talking about some things that are funny, some things that are really sad, but she talks about them in a very funny way, and some things that are just weird. So her family is very special. Her dad works as a taxidermist, and he sort of brings home dead animals all the time, and he is he's a unique character. So the first part of this book is just about her family life and growing up in this small town in Texas and being sort of an outsider, being kind of the weird one because of her father. But there's also one of the chapters is about her problems with childbirth and several miscarriages, and I found that really sad and something that I don't think I've really read much about in books, the unsuccessful pregnancy. So I thought that was really interesting as well. I'm finding this very entertaining, and sort of I feel like I'm gobbling this up because it's kind of hard to put down once you get into reading this. So it's I would say so far that I'm about halfway through. I would say so far that it's sort of a combination of wincing and laughing. Halfway through, we'll probably finish this this weekend because this is going so fast. So my main fiction book I'm currently reading is a book I'm reading for a book club, and it is The Last Quarter of the Moon by Zijian. Zijian, yeah. This is a book translated from the Chinese, and it is a story of indigenous people in China. So it's sort of the Evenki, a tribe of reindeer herders and wanderers of the remote forests of northeastern China. So it's the borders are linked to Russia, I think. This is the choice for February for Tales & Co., which is hosted by a skeptical reader, Yamini from Skeptical Reader. And this is actually my pick for my nomination for the February read. So I was really excited that this was the choice, that this was the final choice for February. I've had this on my shelves for a while, and I was just happy to finally have an excuse to start reading this. I'm finding this really interesting. Because a lot of the things sort of remind me also of The Great Soul of Siberia, which is a nonfiction book about the Siberian tiger. But there is sort of the ideas of the mythology around the Siberian tiger and the spirituality of the people living close to the Siberian tiger sort of is reminiscent of sort of the ideas of these this tribe and these characters and how they view the natural world around them. There's a part in the beginning where the main character, the narrator's sister, is sick, and she's close to death, and then there's a deer dies, and then her sister returns to health. And so it's sort of like the deer was the deer's life was taken to create balance in order to get her sister well. So it's the way that they grieve the deer's passing afterwards, make a tribute for it. And I just the way that they talk about the natural world and how it's linked to life and death and their lives just is reminiscent of The Great Soul of Siberia, and something I'm really, really fascinated by. So far, this is really interesting. I have only read 26 pages, so not very far in. I will be continuing on reading this in February for the Tales & Co. Book Club. Lastly, a book that I have just started, so barely started, is this cover, doesn't tell you much, but it's just called, let's see if I can find the title page for this, Madame Curie, a biography by Eve Curie, translated by Vincent Sheehan. So this is a biography of Madame Curie by her daughter, and I decided that I would pick this book up for February, which is a month-long like reading challenge hosted by Lauren and the Books, where you read books about women or celebrating women of the world and literature and things like that. I decided to pick this up for February because it's a biography about a very famous woman scientist, and she's definitely definitely one of the most important scientists of our like existence, and especially of the 20th century. So I've had this for a while, and I've been really, really eager to pick it up since I read The Emperor of All Maladies by Siddhartha Mukherjee, which is a biography of cancer. And there's some talk about her and her husband's discovery of radium. So there was talk about her, like, there was talk about her in The Emperor of All Maladies. So I've been wanting to pick this up since I read that. I thought that it was the perfect time to read this in February to celebrate some female scientists who've had a big impact on the world. So yeah, so those were all of the books that I'm currently reading and what I'm planning to read in the weekend and a few days to come. I would love to hear what you're reading, or if you're reading... if you've read any of these, I would love to hear your thoughts. If you are reading something good for February, I would love to hear it. I hope you're having a really good day and weekend, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.